body bags where whore lies.
Now take my bitch. She won't complain about shit cause she's my hoe. She don't belong to a trick, so when you fuck her and give her all your cash, I get paid. I put my foot in her ass, I won't marry the bitch and give her half, I get mohead. And then I laugh at that one bitch shit. I got a gang of hoes, I get freak ass lick these balls and toes.
Now stupid little bitches get tossed if they don't realize that I'm the motherfucking boss. Come on down and get your ass pinched, and if you talk shit, get your ass lynched. Cause I'm the B, the I, the T, the C, the H, the K, the I, the L, the L, the...
Yo, what's up everybody? Welcome to week 59 here on Body Bags. I am your host, Moodz616, and thank you once again for dropping in on the Sunday, guys. Alrighty, week 59 is here, and it is a disease-themed week here on Body Bags. So, I believe this theme week was chosen by Steve, which is very cool. There's definitely lots of disease horror films out there. Now, the film I chose this week is one that I've always really been a big fan of my entire life. I remember seeing this film, you know, probably 20 years ago for the first time and just being blown away by it. I always liked this film, thought it was a very cool idea. Canada's own probably most prestigious horror director of all that ever came out of Canada, in my opinion, from 1975, David Cronenberg's Shivers. Very, very cool stuff. But getting into the plot of this one. Now, your film starts out with a basically a murder-suicide. There's a doctor. He's just murdered what you find out to be his test subject. But anyways, this doctor murders this test subject, or this girl, this 19-year-old girl, and then commits suicide himself. And then you sooner than later, you find out that this doctor, you know, he wasn't actually just sick in the fucking head. He actually killed the girl for a reason. Now, the specific doctor was actually doing tests on her. He was trying to develop a parasite that would actually help people, help people with their dysfunctional, you know, organs and stuff in their bodies. So they figured, you know, parasites for the most part are actually very bad for you. But this doctor was trying to create one that would actually help you. And what he was trying to do was, you know, genetically create this parasite that would go inside your body, and if you had like a broken organ or whatever, it would actually go in there and fix it. But this wasn't the case with this girl. He finds out that, you know, this parasite actually isn't doing what it was supposed to do. She went fucking kind of crazy, so he killed her, and then he actually killed himself. Not really too sure why he killed himself, but anyways. But of course, this girl was very kind of sexually active, especially with the men in her own building. Now, she kind of spread this parasitic disease to other people throughout the building, and of course, it spread to, you know, a bunch of other people. Now, the thing is with this parasite is that once you get infected by it with this parasite, it actually kind of it turns you completely crazy, and it's actually in a sexual sense. It makes you go fucking sexual nuts. You know, you see someone, you basically jump them and you try to, you know, fucking fuck them to death and shit. So it's kind of an interesting premise for a film. So, of course, people start getting infected in this building and it starts spreading like the plague, really. So now they need to figure out how to stop the spread of this disease. So, but yeah, so that's basically the general premise of your film here. Very, very, very interesting film. I've always been totally disgusted by the look of the parasites in this film. I think they look completely nasty. They kind of look like... they look like moving pieces of shit, actually. It's fucking gross. Joe Silver stars as one of the doctors in this film. He's one of the investigative doctors trying to figure out why his colleague, the guy at the beginning of the film, actually killed this girl and stuff. And, of course, they figure out why, because this parasite had gone wrong and stuff. But he does a really great job. Joe Silver, the late Joe Silver. But fantastic performance in this film. But yeah, the effects in this movie are awesome for 1975. Really cool stuff with, you know, parasites kind of, you know, bubbling out of people's stomachs and, you know, going into girls' orifices and stuff like that. Really cool premise, man. It's just, I love the whole idea of this film. You know, it was kind of spread by, you know, by sex, and it created like these real sexual monsters and stuff. I think that idea is very cool. So basically the entire film is kind of like one horror orgy of fun, pretty cool stuff. But yeah, I think David Cronenberg's direction in this film is really fantastic. I know that Arrow just put out an edition of this film, and I was actually going to pick it up just the other day, and I heard that there's actually scenes that are a little bit cut in the film, which I was super disappointed by that. This is like a Dutch release, because the old Image release is so far to print and stuff, so I ended up having to grab this one years ago, or a couple years back or whatnot. But yeah, I was really saddened to hear that Arrow's release of this film is a little bit cut. So that's pretty interesting, actually. But yeah, getting back to the film, I think David Cronenberg's direction in the film is fantastic. I love the characters. Of course, you've got the beautiful Barbara Steele in this film, too. She's fantastic in this one. Of course, you get to see her boobs in this film. It's pretty awesome. Really great performances all around in this one. I think it's fantastic. And it just creates that kind of natural horror atmosphere, you know, of these people being affected, and they're just like, they're kind of like, they almost act zombie-ish, you know, they don't really say anything. They're like, the parasites is, you know, the disease parasites have created like almost like a zombie-like character. They don't say anything, and they're kind of fast-moving too and stuff like that too, but they really don't have any control over their sexual urges. I love that premise. I think it's fantastic. So but yeah, you know, there's not really a whole lot to say about this film. This edition, you know, it's a shitty full screen edition, you know, sounds not overly that great, but it still does its trick. So I would highly recommend Shivers. It's a fantastic film if you've never seen this one. One of David Cronenberg's very, very early films. Actually, one of his first full-length films, actually. But yeah, I highly recommend Shivers. If I had to rate this one, I'd probably give it about a 7.5 out of 10. Great effects for the time. They always kind of gross me out, so very cool stuff. And love the end scene in this film. It's fantastic. It's in the swimming pool. Really good stuff. But yeah, check out Shivers. Fantastic movie. So that's going to do it here for week 59 on Body Bags. Good thing I'm done, because I think I'm just developing the hiccups here. It's kind of fucking odd. But yeah, week 59 here. See you guys next week with week 60. And I believe, I don't know what the theme is. I don't know. Like I say every week. Anyways, guys, I'll check you then. Peace out.